suddenly realize that you've been so good to me. Your mercy is everlasting, undenying, and overwhelming. Who am I that you are mindful of? Who am I that you pick my calls when I come?
And welcome, ladies and gentlemen. Good evening to you all. We are here today on the Health of Virtue and actually Men's Fellowship. They're joined together and we're here to speak about is it good, is it a biblical for a girl and a boy to be just friends? And please come and be with us and join us as we are about to go on this exciting journey. And we welcome you all. They are here to tell us what is it that is expected of us to get out of this place and what can we learn after this.
Thank you guys. Tonight, so our topic is can men and women really just be friends? And just friends. So what we're expecting here is to understand whether or not can this thing really happen? And if it cannot, why? If it can, are there any boundaries, or is it the same friendship as I have with my male friends? You know, because we are facing a lot of troubles out there, because the older generation believes strongly that this cannot happen. But what we see nowadays is that a lot of young people are being friends with cross-gender. So we are expecting to hear people's views. We are expecting to learn a lot from tonight. Thank you.
Yeah, it's very good. It's going to be very interesting, and actually we're going to be looking at it in the perspective of the body of Christ within the church, because it does happen between a brother and a sister. So we want to actually come up to a conclusion whether is it really possible for a male and a female to just be friends and then it ends like that, or if not, then how do we make sure that they remain friends and no one gets hurt in the process? So it's going to be very interesting.
Thank you, my sister. Thank you, my brother. Well, you have had it all on campus. Come and join us as we are about to tackle it in from deep.
These things happen, and it is so sad because let us play the borders first, because yeah, we tend to deviate when it comes to such topics. Guys, we are brothers and sisters. We love you. Right, and
yeah.
So since we are brothers and sisters, we're going to be looking at it in the perspective of a brother and a sister within the church, right? Yes. So, and obviously a brother and sister, they are friends, right? So now, I feel like it's even more, should I call it dangerous? I'm not sure, guys, but when it comes to church, brother and sister, marriage, that's all we think of. So, yeah, we started as friends, maybe we're courting, and then, yeah, later he's going to propose to me, or no, yeah, I will propose to her. Only to find that, no, actually, no, that's not actually what I had in mind, you know. And it's so sad because sometimes you can get to a point where now, when it gets to a point where the other one is thinking, okay, you're my other half, but then the other one is like, no, we're not in the same page. And it's going to get to a point where Muntus will have from the church and be like, I can't stand seeing you two guys be together, knowing exactly that I'm your friend and we've been through a lot.
And I'm just going to ask a few people, what were they expecting when they were coming here? Or why are they here? All right? So I'm going to start with my sister over here. Guys, please, can you just listen to her and listen why she came? Yeah, my sister. Okay, first of all, please state your name and then you tell us. Did you guys hear her name?
No.
Okay. So she's telling us that she was once a friend with a male guy. It did not end well. Alright? So it did not end. Are there people who can relate to her, guys?
No.
Alright. Okay. Let's get another male. And let's see. Oh, let's get a male.
Yeah, guys, my name is Edza. Yeah, it's one of the big things.
but a friend. Like most of these guys, to start off, they have to be there. Like, so someone who is there. Someone whom you are yourself. Your real self. I mean, when the person is there, it must be your real self. Right? It must be as if you are on your own. That's how transparent you need to be to a friend. Right? So, they are there for you in different spheres of your life. It could be academic, physical, like Tulu said, emotional, financial, I'm not.
Throw it away, which means that if that situation of you as possible. But then the yes part is conditional.
Yes.
What people are trying to echo right now is that there has to be boundaries. And apparently submarine under Nothando, when she says, if your intentions are clear, if you walk into the relationship, the friendship. Your friendship is a relationship. But friendship is a relationship. So if you walk into a friendship with your intentions clear, saying that I want you to be my friend, then the friendship becomes clear. Now if you walk in trying to be a friend and then when you wait for an opportunity, you're nothing else but a parasite. Because you are opportunistic in the sense that you're lying to yourself and you're even lying to him, right? Or him, for that matter. Trying to answer Desmond's question, I feel like what we fail to understand right now is that people have their agency, right? In a sense that when you get into a relationship, it's two individuals, right? And that person has their agency, they can decide whatever they want to, right? So I wouldn't have a problem if my wife as a main friend, because I would assume that she wouldn't have a problem with me. I would assume that she wouldn't have a problem with me having a female friend. Because can I expound?
Yes.
Because at the same time, when you existed for, let's say you get married for 30 years, you existed for 30 years. In between those 30 years, you have developed friendships. So now, in one day, you have to erase each and everyone that has been in your life. People of God, then we'd be honest with ourselves. So if I tell her that this is my friend, then she is my friend. If I'm saying this is my friend, but she's not really a friend, she's something else, then...
So,
are you waving at me?
No.
Oh, okay. So, I believe... Okay, let me repeat it. I believe that we are people of God. So, if I tell her that this is my friend, then I'm pure. My intentions are pure. I'm telling her that this is the person that I don't consider as something else, but I consider as a friend, and I'm honest in my approach. So I don't see that being a problem.
Yeah. Right. Yeah.
Hi guys, my name is Sylvia. I have a bit of a problem because it seems like we are now assuming for the, like, we plan these things.
Yeah.
Whereas sometimes you are just friends. Like, I don't know, for me, most of the people that I am friends with, myself included, I didn't, it just happens, you get what I'm saying? So this thing happened, if you come with intentions, like, I don't get, because sometimes you just meet people and then you find for you have the same interest and then you keep talking until you become a friendship. So how then do you deal, what do we say about friendships that
I would like to respond to leaders.
And ish, okay. The hand of it went up. Sorry. So don't worry, we're gonna still have another question and answer. So after him, we're gonna go to two speakers, but this person is here. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
The question that I have is for this one to also I am on. The Bible it says well right to me. It says that God must lead to older people in the congregation as fathers and women in the congregation as mothers and then to women that are younger ones as sisters as well. So I think that principle should be the one that governs our relationships. That's the first thing. The second thing is that we are constantly battling with sin. So with you having the principle of that each and every single person is not married to, you sort of viewing them as your sister, you as an individual have a responsibility as a Christian to fight against your flesh, because obviously we are in a fallen nature. And it, even if you can say, okay, it's impossible, you're just friends, so you develop such feelings to a large extent. And so I think it's you viewing a person as a sister of the brother, and then you as an individual, as a Christian, fighting that flesh and the temptation yourself, so to keep those boundaries and whatever.
Alright. We're gonna take hands later.
So, we are friends. What are our boundaries? I believe that if you've got a certain standard, you are both Christians, you know certain things that you shouldn't do as Christians. Can I just go to the book of 1 Timothy? Yes. The book of 1 Timothy chapter 4 verse 12, it says, don't let anyone look down on you because you are young, but set an example for the believers in speech, in conduct, in love, in faith, and in purity. So, some of the friendships that we have, they, to some extent, when I grew up, my mother used to tell me that be careful of what people think of you because you're a Christian. You're still an example to them. You know, so as you are friends, there's too many questions that are arising. Don't make people question the kind of a person that you are because of how you are acting with your friends, with your guy friend. You know, remember I said, yes, I believe in that. You know, so I'm a friend with Umas Ole. The way we conduct ourselves, what does it say to other people? You know, and as I've said, it gets to a point where it gets complicated. And now, when it starts being complicated, it's a different stage, you know. So now he's now interested in me. Where do we go from there? You know, where do we go from there? So if you knew from the beginning what you were expecting from the friendship, some people, it ends up being, the relationship, it just breaks after the guy proposes. And guys, just to say something that I usually hear, we know what we want as women. It's unfortunate because when we know what we want, we know it. When we say we want a good looking man, we want that. Just to say.
Talk about issues, it's friendship, right? It's unfortunate because sometimes you say
this is my, I would say this is my friend, and then it's questionable. But when the friendship is real, we are able to talk about things. And moving from here, if there's something complicated, you talk about it as well. So, and lastly, Proverbs chapter 4, verse 23. Above all else, guard your heart, for everything you do flows from it. So, it's just as it is. As friends, guard your heart, because everything that you do, it flows from your heart.
She ready for both of us.
Church doesn't address.
If I came here to bombard you guys with a sermon, then I would have failed the task of today. There's a lot of chaff of sermons out there. You can Google them, but that's not what I'm going to talk about today. So, biggest risk is sex. So for me, sex cannot be a mistake. Sex cannot, you cannot say, can ever, you can't blame a relationship for sex. It's always premeditated. Both parties premeditated. It cannot happen as a mistake. I'll tell you why it cannot happen as a mistake. The process to sex is too long. So therefore, as you are undressing, the angels will take you on the shoulder and hide you. So you get what I mean?
Yeah.
So the problem is sex. But when you've got a relationship with a friend, who will you end up sleeping with? Then the problem is not a friend with a woman or anything. The problem is you. So that's the first rough edged point as I can give you. The second point is that the Bible says the devil will never tempt you from something you don't like. The devil tempts you from your desires. So now, the problem is, in this case, what are your desires? So, you cannot bring your desires and say this can't exist. Because the problem is not this, the problem is your desires. Secondly, we came to Christ different. Right? Others have engaged in sex. And there's one thing that happens to you when you engage in sex before you get born again, is that you carry a load of a brick. It hangs on your neck everywhere you go. Because every woman you see, you're gonna imagine it. Because you know how it feels to chase somebody. So now, why am I talking about this? Why am I bringing this? Because the church of voices is this. Secondly, before I sit down, I'll ruffle some feathers. There's a key concept, which is, there's what we call untold expectations. Women are good at this. Like women are those ladies that only one can say, for a crush on so-and-so, and the person has no idea.
Yeah.
Like you can have a crush on TV, that it's not supposed to be my husband. They can live on that, feed on it. For years, there's untold expectations. So if you get into a friendship and the expectations are not sorted out, then there's a problem. Because the truth is, the more time you spend with someone, by nature, no matter how spiritual you are, you're gonna fall for them. Six of those relate to us, how we So it plays a very critical role. You can go and read the Exodus 20. And then the other one that I want to talk about, there's a key issue here which is a very confusing issue, the issue of feelings. You fall for someone, you feel something for someone. Others say, feel butterflies. Others say, that's the amount of water going up and ask for that thing. You can almost put the idea here. So, my wife spoke about, someone spoke about boundaries, my wife spoke about boundaries. The truth is that most friendships are useless. That is absolutely true. Actually, 80% of friendships are useless. Why am I saying that? You don't grow from them. Just addiction. So now, it's just addiction. You are addicted to this lady, you eat together and rest, you think you are friends. This guy helps you with your assignment, you think he cares. So, you start aligning your heart with all those assumptions. You assume that what bestie is me and her. I told a cat friend once to say, you say that your friends, she said yes. I said to her, since you are she was going through exclusion, I said, you mark a list for me who's going to call you from CAF when you're home in Eastern Cape. Only one person called her from home. She was getting excluded, she went home for a year, only one person called her. And I said to her, that's your friend. The rest of the other people are going into missions, open airs, prayer. It was just same comradeship. So we're moving that direction. And then the last thing, before I talk too much. If you don't get your wife or your husband here, which is Kev, where do you expect to get one?
Such issues, so that we can be better Christians and so that we can be knowledgeable.
and we can be consistent with the way.
That is very well said, and I feel that we need to have this conversation. And then I have my sister again.
I have my sister calling in. My sister, what have you grabbed today?
Yeah, dating is not a sin, but got your heart. And you know, pray, man, pray. Talk to God with everything, with every decision. Don't just jump and run. And beware of the flesh, because it's a thing. You know? The thing is, we are not taught this at church, so now you get to know. So hopefully I won't do it.
With my brother and my brother, what have you bought? What have you been in your system today?
It was a very powerful session, eh? And to be honest, I just realized there were a couple of friends that I've been keeping. Not really friends, because according to the definition of friendship that I got, like, you need to be able to grow with these people. And I just had a mini young view of my life and my friends. And honestly, some of them, they were just not up to par. So it was a very insightful thing. And it actually taught me a thing or two in terms of who to look out for. I mean, when it's time for Adam to wake up. Like, it taught me a couple of things. You know. So it was quite an informative session.
Thank you very much, Ezra. With all that has been said, I would like to say thank you guys for watching. And this is us, Kev, with Ken, a woman and a man. Just be friends. Thank you for watching. We'll see you next time.
The temple, you are the voice, we are your song. You are our God, we are your people, you are the light, we stand in awe.